Morning. Hey, Sam. Sam, you need to tell me how everything's going. Looks new. You can't even see it on here. I'll send you a picture. Good morning. Good morning. Cool. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. I see y'all coming in. Good morning. Good morning. Welcome. Welcome. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. How y'all doing this morning? Are y'all coming in fast? It is 5 a.m. Oh, I miss you so much. Yeah, yes. Please, 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 please. As soon as you get home, let me know and I'll take you to breakfast or lunch. For sure. Good morning. Welcome. Welcome. How y'all doing this morning? Tanisha, I hate I missed you when you were in town. Good morning. Welcome. Welcome. How y'all doing? Welcome. Welcome. How y'all doing this morning? This morning I am listening to Dear No One by Tori Kelly. It's really a really dope song. She talks about finding really wholeness in herself and then just waiting until the right moment when God connects her to her soulmate. It is really, really a dope song. So if you've never listened to that, that is Dear No One by Tori Kelly. And it speaks about just wholeness and waiting on God's divine timing for what needs to happen next. What needs to happen next? It's Friday. And I hope you guys are excited. You should be excited about the weekend. You should be excited about life. I always am. It's early in the morning, getting fresh. And I got something. We've been in John 15, and I want to show you something God revealed to me this morning. We're going to talk about stewardship. How are you caring for it? Yesterday, I talked to you about what's in your mouth, putting it in your mouth, your miracle in your mouth. But what happens once you get the things that you've been believing God for? I've talked about stewardship before, but God gave me a completely different perspective. I remember when I was growing up, my mother would tell me, take care of the things that I'm giving you. Take care of the things that I've given you. And she would always say, you need to take care of what I'm giving you, right? I'm not going to give you anything else if you can't take care of what I have for you. And I'm going to show you how God showed me this in connection to love and connection to in this chapter 15 when he tells us to remain in his love. This morning, I got on my Paris t-shirt. I'm in a travel mood. I think this came from my friend Chala. And my Paris coffee mug that also talks about being in Paris. I speak a little bit of French. I took French in high school. I've been playing around over the last year with picking up French again. If you're just logging on, good morning. Welcome to Coffee and Conversations. I am LaKisha Johnson. So do me a favor, go share this video live right now. Put it in someone else's hands so that they can experience the word of God this morning. I am Facebook Live and Instagram Live. We will be back YouTube Live next week. We were having a couple of glitches on YouTube. We'll be back YouTube Live next week. So let me pray and get started. Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your peace. We thank you for your joy. We just thank you for all that you are. We thank you for correction in the word, for teaching us to be better stewards, for teaching us how to care for the things that you give us. We thank you for that right now in the name of Jesus. I ask that you go before the people today, that you bless them. Lord God, that this word not fall on deaf ears, that it be implanted in their hearts so that they can multiply. For your glory alone, we thank you, Holy Ghost, for all that you are. Now let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight. Father, we thank you for miracle signs and wonder impartation. Let your glory be in this devotional. Let your glory be throughout this day. Let your glory be in our lives. I plead the blood of Jesus over every person watching this. that as they go through the weekend, Lord God, they will not be beguiled. They will not be tempted to do ungodliness, Lord God, that they will remain in faith and stand steadfast in your faithfulness. Now, Holy Ghost, go do only what you can do in Jesus' name. Good. Danielle, day two of positivity, for sure. Day two of being positive and remaining steadfast and being positive. I'm just so grateful for all that God has done. My light is a little different, but I realized I didn't turn the light on, but I'm not going to get up. So I want to talk to you this morning about stewardship, how you're caring for the things of God. Remember, we've been in John 15 and we've been reading about abiding in God and abiding in his love. And I want to caution you of something. It is so easy for you to get off this abide task. Or it's easy for you to get disconnected from abiding in him, to assume you're all good. And God has been dealing with me about having these spirituality checks, right? Oh, hold on. I see Deshauna Austin is on and I need to shout her out this morning. Sam, I was talking to her on Instagram, is my baby, and she took care of my hair for a long time. And then she went and pursued other career interests. And she did an amazing job and always kept my hair healthy. So I've kind of been looking for someone new to do my hair outside the beauty school. And Deshauna Austin took care of me yesterday. And so, Deshauna, I just want to appreciate, I want to say thank you. Thank you for also accommodating my schedule. My schedule is real crazy sometimes, and it's hard for me to get things scheduled. And Deshauna got me in yesterday, and she clipped my ends, and she did something for me. It's a little dark in here, but I wanted some purple in my hair, and she added some purple in my hair. So thank you, Deshauna, yesterday for accommodating my schedule, for doing my hair just like I wanted it, for making sure my hair was healthy. So thank you, Deshauna. I appreciate you. I called her at the last minute, and she was like, yep, I got you. Get here. And I was even a little bit late, and she still made sure I was taken care of. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. For taking care of it. So here's something funny about this too. And I'm gonna talk to y'all about my hair and how I don't really even think to take care of my hair. And God has been dealing with me all this morning about stewardship, about the things that he gives you, even some of the simple things like your car, everything. So let's get into the scripture. So we're in John and we're going in between the 9th and the 11th verse. And he's talking to them even about loving him. And he's saying to them, he's saying, love me. Love me like this. This is what I need to do. He says, so we get to the 9th verse. He said, when you produce much fruit, we're talking about producing much fruit. He said, I've loved you even though the Father has loved me. Remain in my love. When you obey my commandments, you remain in my love. Just as I obey my Father's commandments and remain in his love, I've told you these things so that you would be filled with joy, so that you would be filled with joy. So remaining in his love so that you would be filled with joy. There's more to this. Yes, your joy will overflow. This is my commandment. Love each other in the same way I've loved you. There is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's friends. Now, here's where I want to show you what God showed me. There are principles of biblical stewardship. And a lot of times we have been or spending time believing God for something. We ask God for something. We petition God for things. And God has shown us here, remain in my love, because if you remain in God's love, you'll properly handle the things of God. You'll properly handle the things of God. And it is so easy to get lazy. It is so easy to deal with things haphazardly. It is so easy to do that because life just happens. But God is trying to teach us stewardship in absolutely everything. We manage our resources for God. We manage our relationships for God. I remember the very first time I was frustrated over one of my sons, and God, and I was going on, and I'm his mama, and I gave birth to him. And I said the words, I brought you into this world and I'll take you out. And the Lord corrected me. No, I brought him into this world. And I'm the only one that can take him out. I brought him into this world, not you. Not you. He may have came through you. You may have procreated. You may have done the act, but I brought him into this world. And I'm the only one that can take him out this world. He doesn't belong to you, LaKisha. He is something that I gave you to manage. Someone I gave you to love while you're here. You're taking this thing way too far. And we do that with our relationships. And so God has called us to be stewardship. And so I talked to you about the miracle in your mouth. I talked to you about getting the thing. You believe God for some things. Things happened in your life. But how are you caring for the things that God gave you? What does stewardship look like in your life today? And often we think of stewardship only in terms of money. And stewardship is not just in terms of money. Stewardship is also in the relationships that God give you, the call that you have on your life. And we're going to talk about the parable of the talents when we know what happened when the man gave them something and when they didn't properly handle what God has given them. Got the resources, the time, the jobs, the gifts, the talents. We only get to manage that. Those don't belong to us. Everything we have is what we're supposed to manage. We're supposed to manage. So if the only way, and I'm just being honest, the only way to manage this properly is that we remain in Christ's love. The love of Christ will properly teach you to manage anything in your life. Yesterday, I was on the phone with four women, and it's funny how God does. And we were talking, and later, I mean, we were just esteeming each other. And one of the ladies was talking about what happens when a crisis comes in our life. And she said to me, she said, when I come into a crisis situation, I shut up first. She said, and then the second thing I do is I choose to respond to the situation. No matter what the situation is, I choose to respond to the situation in love. And that's what Christ was saying. If you remain in me, if you remain in my love, then you're going to be in joy. If you remain in your love and handling your relationships with people, if you remain in love, you won't get exhausted because you will get to receive and deal with this relationship. And he says here in this 15th verse, and receive the joy that's promised for remaining in love. A lot of times we don't experience the joy we need to experience with the relationships because we're not remaining in his love. And I'm talking to you like, wait a minute, I got bills. Even your bill collectors remaining in love. One of my sons was dealing with a bill, a situation. I said, call them. Stay humble. Talk to them. He called and he talked to them. And two situations got worked out. I said, I told you, just a conversation, being humble, being meek, being lowly. And so we're supposed to be stewards. And it's supposed to intersect the faith, the word, the economics. All of this is supposed to intersect. So he tells you here, if you'll remain in my love, then you're going to experience joy always. The Lord's blessings don't come with sorrow. If the Lord bless you with a house, if the Lord bless you with a car, if the Lord bless you with a marriage, if the Lord, and even if you went into a marriage on your own and it wasn't on the blessing of God, he still expects you to have stewardship in your relationships. You got to have stewardships in your relationship. In the 24th Psalms, it says, the earth is the Lord's and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. You have got to begin to identify that everything in your world belongs to God. It does not belong to you. We have a hard time with people because we don't conceptually look at the fact that people belong to God. Well, what if they treat me wrong? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. What if they acting up? It doesn't matter. You supposed to stay fluid no matter what. You supposed to remain in his love no matter what. You supposed to act accordingly no matter what. You supposed to bless the person and it'll heap the coals on your head. So in the beginning of Genesis, God created everything. He puts Adam in the garden of work and he says, here, manage or administrate. Some of y'all believed God for a job. You had nothing. Then you got what God, what you were believing God for, now you complain about your job. Now you complain about your job, or you half go to work, or you halfway do a job. And then you upset because you're not receiving the joy from the job, but you're not remaining in love towards your job. You're not managing properly, being a steward. That's what stewardship is. Managing properly what God gives you. You're not properly managing what God gives you, then you're frustrated by it. But the job didn't change. This is the same job you believed for. Were the people on there, were my supervisor, were my boss? It doesn't matter what the other people look like. It doesn't matter what the other people act like. You believed God for this. He gave you this. If you did believe God for it, you needed it, because we're supposed to work in it. We're supposed to work for it. So you got it. And then you complain about what God gave you. You're complaining about what he gave you, but you believed him for it. You're managing it wrongly, and it's not reciprocating the joy that you needed to reciprocate, because you're not dealing with the circumstance in love. And you're not dealing with it love. Stewardship expresses our obedience towards. Ability to respond to this in love and in the things of God. Still your responsibility. Still your responsibility to respond to this thing the way the Lord will have you to respond to it. Deuteronomy 8 and 17 says, my power and the strength of my hands have produced this wealth for me. That's what wrong counsel says. But right counsel, Deuteronomy 8, 18 says, remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you the ability to produce wealth. A lot of times when we get our jobs or in our careers or our business or our things are flowing, we forget that it is God that gives you the ability to produce wealth. And anytime we get outside his love, anytime we forget where we came from, then we handle things haphazardly and from a position in which God can't get the glory out of it. So it is our responsibility. It is our responsibility to be good stewards on everything. So it's not your job, whether you feel like it's glorious or not, your job. Remember the Lord God for you. It is he who gives you the ability to produce wealth. Not you, not your talents, not your gifts. It's him that gives you the ability to produce wealth. So anytime you handle it haphazardly, you're forgetting the responsibility that comes with God's manager. One of the reasons things don't get handled appropriately is because we don't understand our stewardship. We don't understand how we're supposed to care for things. You believed God for this house. You wanted a house. You needed a place to stay. You was homeless at one point. You weren't. You didn't have. God gives you a house, right? He gives you a place to stay. He provides shelter for you. You won't even clean up your house. You won't even keep your house clean. You won't even wash your clothes. You won't fold your clothes up. You won't take care of the stuff that God gave you. There's a responsibility to your blessing. There's a responsibility to the people that God put in your life. I'm going to be honest. I ran into a woman of God. I ran into her the other day, and I understand we all have bad days, but I ran into her the other day, and the look that she had on her face. And she's called to ministry, right? There's a responsibility when we call to ministry of how we handle people. I can't go to the restaurant treating people any kind of way. I can't do that even if it's not me called in ministry. Just me saying that I'm a child of God. There's a responsibility to how I treat the people that I'm connected to. So I use people. You got to use people's name when you're in restaurants. You talk to people. You don't mistreat people. Even the people that are in your life, period. That's what he was showing me. Stewardship expresses this love. And if you're remaining in love, even when people are doing something they don't have any business, you know that you are to remain in love always. There is a responsibility. There's a responsibility. Nothing belongs to us. Your kids don't belong to you. Your husband don't belong to you. Your ministry don't belong to you. Your business don't belong to you. Your job doesn't belong to you. And so if you understand that, you have rights, but there is a responsibility to what God is calling you. You have to manage what God has. I shouldn't walk in your house and your house is dirty. You needed a place to stay. God provided a place to stay. See, the problem is you don't understand God as your provider. God is your provider. You think your job provided. You think your business provided. You think, no, God is your provider. Don't forget who provides for you. Don't forget who blesses the work of your hands. Don't forget that. And so if he's provided you a place to stay, he's provided you a car, then you got to operate in stewardship. What do the inside of your car look like? I'm on my way to get my car done. My car cleans out today. I try to get it cleaned every 2 weeks. I understand you got small children. That's fine. That's not an excuse for you not to be a good steward over what God told you. I understand that you work bad hours. That's fine. That's not an excuse for you not to be a steward over what God gave you. It's not an excuse. Excuses, my uncle says all the time, excuses are just a lie. So if God provides these things for you and he's giving you the things that you need, then your stewardship, your responsibility to these things, you have responsibilities. Riches and honor come from you, and you are the ruler of everything. Power and might are in your hand. It is your hand to make great and to give strength to all. That's 1 Chronicles 29:12. You need to remember who provides, who gave you, who blessed you with your kids. And I know some of you were, I got pregnant and I wasn't trying. It don't matter. I had a miscarriage. That baby didn't come into fruition, right? If your kids are here, they're here by design. They're not here by accident. So stop treating them like an accident and remember the responsibility to your relationships. Also, accountability. A steward is one who manages the possessions of another. So we're accountable. God entrusted people, things, this business, everything in your care, and he's watching to see what you're gonna do with what he gave you. He's watching to see. I want to hear, well done, thou good and faithful servant. I want to hear, well done, thou good and faithful servant. Well done in your relationships. Well done in how you treat people. Well done in whether or not you remained in my love. I want to hear, well done, thou good and faithful servant. And that's what he's going to look. I want to show you something else. So there's a responsibility and there's a principle of accountable. You're accountable. Remember when in Matthew it says you're accountable for every word that comes out your mouth? You're accountable for absolutely everything that you do. So when you get it and God blesses you with it, you got to remain in love. You got to handle everything around you as Jesus would handle everything around you. Oh my gosh, I got this house. I got, well, it don't seem like much. It doesn't matter. I live in an apartment. Every day God instructs me what my house should look like. Get up, LaKisha. Make sure your laundry is done. When people come in your house, it should represent the kingdom. It should represent excellence. People shouldn't have to get in your car and you got to move stuff out the way because your car is nasty or whatever else. It should represent kingdom. It should represent excellence. Your attitude towards people should represent kingdom, should represent excellence. You're accountable for absolutely everything you do. There's a principle. So we know that the parable of the talents, God entrusted authority over the creation for us to use. And we're not supposed to rule over it how we see fit. You got a gift, right? I got a gift to write. God has been dealing with me about writing more. He says, you need to get these books produced. You need to get this stuff out here. If you don't, you're not being a good steward. And we know what happens in the parable of the talents. The one man that didn't utilize his talent, he gave that talent away for someone else. You don't want to lose what God has given you because you're handling it haphazardly. I have a nonprofit organization, and the Lord had been dealing with me about operating in excellence and operating as if I'm really getting paid for it. And the budget for it is big. He said, operate as if you're already there. You're faithing for it. So operate as if you already have it. Operate like it's already there. You're going to be accountable for everything you've administered, been given, your time, your money, your abilities, information, wisdom. You can't, if God, stewardship over, if God gives you a word on something, or you've been sitting on coffee and conversation and we talking about excellence and we talking about kingdom, God is going to hold you accountable for whether or not you receive that word. God is going to hold you accountable for how you talk about people, how you treat people. I told you the other day, I said something about somebody, I have absolutely nothing. It wasn't anything bad, but it wasn't necessary. And my spirit felt so grieved. God said, oh, there go your accountability. I don't ever want to feel like that again. He's going to hold you accountable for how you used your authority. If you're in a supervisor or a leadership people, how you led, how you talked to, how you treated, how you cultivated, how you did, you're going to be accountable for every relationship. I want to leave you with this. Colossians 3, 23 and 24 says, whatever you do, work at it with all your heart as working for the Lord, not for men, since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward. It is the Lord Christ you are serving. If you will take the attitude into every relationship, that everything that you have, into your car, into your business, if you teach school, what you look like when you teach your students, encountering even difficult students, if you will take the attitude into every relationship that I'm going to do this unto the Lord, it will change. You're not going to go to work and steal time, right? Because you're remaining in the things of Christ. You're operating in the mind of Christ. You're not going to steal ink pens and stuff from work. You're not going to take paper from work. You're not going to go to work late. You're not going to treat your boss with contempt. You're not going to treat your coworkers ugly, even if they act ugly. Why? Because you're remaining in God's love and the joy. Even if your husband is being ugly or acting ugly, you're not going to act ugly back towards them. Even if your kids are being ugly, it doesn't give you room to mistreat. Why? Because you're going to remain in Christ's love and you're going to experience the joy of it. And you're going to get your butt in a position and start praying for the things around you that are not acting. God already told you, if you remain in me, then the authority and the power in your mouth will change the circumstance and the situation. But you got to do everything that you do as unto the Lord, as unto the Lord. Y'all saw changes in coffee and conversation. Why? Because it should be evolving as unto the Lord. I start on time as unto the Lord. I get my butt out of the bed as unto the Lord. I'm becoming a better mom as unto the Lord. When I become a wife, as unto the Lord. I'm a business owner, as unto the Lord. As unto the Lord. Maybe that's what I need to change this devotional to. As unto the Lord. Everything you do should be as unto the Lord. It's not enough for you to say you love and serve Christ. It should be done as unto your friendships, your relationships, as unto the Lord. As unto the Lord, how you treat people, as unto the Lord. When you're somewhere and you have trash, putting your trash up, as unto the Lord. Everything should be done as unto the Lord. When we need to be faithful stewards over everything God gives us, because it glorifies him and it glorifies kingdom, as unto the Lord. When you go to a restaurant and you eat, tip the minimum of 20%. It gives us a bad name as Christians, because I've heard it multiple times. Christians don't tip right. As unto the Lord. Everything you gotta do is as unto the Lord. Even if people getting at you, as unto the Lord. Handle your house as unto the Lord. Handle your car as unto the Lord. Handle your relationships as unto the Lord. That's what stewardship is really about. Doing things as unto the Lord, remaining in his love so your joy can be complete. The reason that you don't have joy in these relationships and jobs is because you're not doing it as unto the Lord. Because if you were doing it as unto the Lord, whenever it didn't go right, it would not consume you. It would not overwhelm you. Why? Because you were doing it as unto the Lord. You were doing it as unto the Lord. I had to share this with you. I talked about it already. I did a whole week on dating, and I remember I was dating and then I had a breakup, right? And I was really devastated. And one of my friends called me and he set the record straight. He said, can I tell you something? He said, the reason that you're so devastated about this relationship is because you got outside of God's will. This relationship should have been done as done to the unto the Lord. That's why I talk about there's no biblical concept of dating. But if you're going to date, you got to date God's kind of way. Got to make sure you're celibate. Got to make sure you're putting boundaries in place and make sure even your dating is unto the Lord. Now, I told y'all about my hair. I'm really not into hair. I really don't care about my hair. But the Lord dealt with me about taking care of my temple, eating right, getting enough sleep, working out, going to make sure my hair is combed, going to make sure my stuff is taken care of. As unto the Lord, this is your temple. LaKisha, I gave you this. If I blessed you with this hair, comb your hair. Make sure your ends are cut. Make sure you're drinking enough water every day. Make sure you're working out. Make sure you're taking care of your body. Don't make excuses for why you're not doing stuff. You may not care about hair. You may not be into hair. But as unto the Lord, take care of your temple. This ain't, you don't belong to you. You belong to me. You don't belong to you. Take care of yourself mentally. Take care of yourself spiritually. You don't belong to me. Take care of my kids mentally, physically. I had to repent and apologize to my kids. I can cook very well for not cooking like I need to for them and providing them with the things that they need because of rush time or my schedule. That's no excuse. God gave you to me. He gave me the ability to be able to cook and provide for you from a health standpoint. I need to make sure I'm taking care of you as unto the Lord, that nothing in my life, nothing in my schedule is too busy for me to take care of you as unto the Lord, as unto the Lord. That's how I should be taking care of those around me. So he dealt with me on that. So I got my butt up yesterday and went and got my hair done. And I was like, oh my gosh, everything as unto the Lord, as no excuses, whether you can afford to or not. And God brought me back to that remembrance. He said, I remember when you couldn't afford to, you still took care of it. So don't haphazardly take care of things because you have an excuse and a reason because it's not done or well unto everything that you do as unto the Lord, remaining in him, remaining in love, staying focused, and you'll have the joy for everything. He'll give you the joy if you remain in his love, remain in the mind of Christ, and deal the situation. You got an issue coming up around you, pray and talk to God. Put your authority, put your mouth on it. Pray and talk about the circumstance and the situation. Declare a word over it. Stop dealing with it in your flesh and make sure you're practicing stewardship over everything God has given you. There is a responsibility to us for kingdom. So kingdom ain't supposed to look raggedy. That's why some people don't want to walk into being a Christian because they're like, I don't want to be no Christian. You see how they act? You see what their houses look like? See, they ain't taking care of their stuff. You see their car when they drove by? Care if it ain't your Benz that you've been believing God for. Take care of your Hyundai as if it's your Benz. Take care of your stuff as if it's unto the Lord. Fold your clothes up, wash, do your laundry. Like everything is, you could not, I think of it from this way. You could not have clothes. You could not have a place to stay. You could not have the things that you need and you want. So take care, be responsible. Operate in biblical stewardship in everything. It's not just about your finances. It's about your house. It's about your relationships. It's about the people that you speak. It's about what your office looks like. Take care of your stuff. I spent three, it's tedious, time consuming. Yeah, had to spend 3-4 hours yesterday cleaning up my house, making sure all my laundry was done, making sure everybody's closets were cleaned out. Doing some stuff because this is as unto the Lord. This don't belong to me anyway. He gave this to me as unto the Lord. Does that make sense? So you can't be believing God for it, thinking all these kingdom things, and you're not operating in kingdom principles. Kingdom principles are reminded on a daily basis that whatever you do unto the Lord. Because at the end of the day, Matthew 25 and 21, his master said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You are faithful over a few things. I'm gonna put you sharp, charge of many, share of your master's joy. And that's here on earth. Stuff will multiply and increase from you when you start practicing stewardship. Some of y'all been believing God for a big house and you won't even take care of your, you won't take care of 500 square feet, but you want 4,000. How you gonna get 4,000 and you won't clean five? How you gonna get that Benz or that Beamer you've been wanting or that Porsche you've been wanting and you won't take care of the Corolla or you won't take care of the Chrysler? How you gonna do it? As unto the Lord, stewardship, biblical stewardship, accountability. That's how we supposed to operate in as kingdom people. And no excuses. No excuses. I don't care how busy your schedule is. God didn't give you what he gave you for you for, and you can't manage it. If he gave you kids, you can manage me. If he gave you a marriage, you can manage me. If he gave you a house, you can manage me. If he gave you a car, you can manage it. He will provide absolutely everything you need. You need to remember he's the provider. He blesses the work of your hands and not you alone. Well, that's it for today. It's the weekend, baby. It's the weekend. That's kingdom. That's what kingdom really is. We want kingdom in so many ways, and we don't want to experience kingdom. We don't want to do the things to replicate the kingdom. If we're going to experience kingdom, we got to replicate the kingdom without excuses. God is tired of us making excuses. Excuses just become lies. Well, I couldn't do it. No, you could. Because if your house ain't clean, but you go out and kick it this weekend, your priorities out of order. I'm just telling you. I can't leave my house till my house is clean. My boys can't leave the house till the house is clean. Then I can't leave the house till the house is clean. Can't do it. Cannot do it. It's just stewardship. Stewardship. Your business. Can I tell y'all this? And then we're gonna go. If God gave you a business, ask him for the excellence for your business. I do business coaching for small business owners. I see people don't want to hear what I got to tell them a lot of times because they don't want to walk into excellence. I pay for excellence. Why? Because it's necessary. I'm representing kingdom. I can't brand, do, build business. He's been dealing with me about my nonprofit organization. I was about to send out some thank you letters and I was going to handwrite on some envelopes. And I promised, I felt like God was sitting at the table and cleared his throat. See, yes, sir. Don't you handwrite on the envelopes. Get your butt up, type, put a label on it and act as if you're a professional. That's stewardship. Going the extra mile, building, branding, taking time. You can't do it, not haphazardly doing things. It makes the kingdom look janky and raggedy. And we ain't just supposed to be no janky and raggedy kingdom. You don't know how to do something? Ask somebody. Stop being cheap. When you pay for things, you're sowing into your business. You're sowing into your business. You're sowing into what God gave you. So you sow into it to provide excellence. Well, that's it for today. I love y'all. I'm not trying to fuss. It's just time for us to make the necessary adjustments so that we can experience the kingdom of God the way that we're supposed to experience it. God is not holding us up. We're holding ourselves up. We're holding ourselves up. I promise you, we're holding ourselves up. I love y'all. I love you enough that when God deals with me on stuff, I got to share it with you. I even got to share my mistakes so that you can learn. So you ain't even got to do the dumb stuff that I've done. You ain't got to do the dumb stuff that I've done. I'm going to share it with you so you can bypass it and be, well, LMJ did it and it got jacked up. So here we go. So I love y'all so much. You know what I'm getting ready to tell you? I need you to go be loved today. If the word has been a blessing to you, you feel led by the Holy Spirit, please go and sow. Know that you're sowing in the good ground. Make sure that you ask the Lord to show you. Show me the areas of my life. Show me the areas of my life that aren't aligned with yours, where I'm not operating in stewardship, where I'm not operating in stewardship. I promise you it's going to work. So excited about all my fall lineup, my guests I'm going to be interviewing. I got Stephen T. Robinson coming. I got Emily McKnight. I got Monty Weatherall. The fall guests are going to be so lit. I promise you they are. God is just doing amazing things in my life, but I got to practice stewardship. Go study the parable of the talents in Matthew. Go read that and study that and ask the Holy Spirit to reveal to you where you're not being a good steward in your life, and watch what God does for you. I promise you, you'll see multiplication and increase when you start practicing stewardship. Not just over your money, over your time, all that time you've been spending on social media, that's not stewardship. All the time you waste, all the time you spend, you can have downtime, but all that time you waste when your business is not handled, that's because you're not practicing stewardship over your time. When you practice stewardship over your time, you'll see the multiplication and the increase. So I need y'all to do me a favor. I need y'all to go be loved today. Hey, if there's anybody on here, I need to speak a blessing over you. If there's anybody on here that is not saved, this is your opportunity. Don't wait. If you've been experiencing these hot temperatures, hell is 10 times of this, 10 times this. Don't wait. This is your opportunity to get to know Christ as Lord and Savior, and we'll help lead you in this. Now, may the blessing of the Lord be with you. May it not bring any sorrow. The blessing doesn't bring any sorrow. May you multiply and increase in the work of your hands. May you be overran with his love, filled with his Holy Spirit, and understand all that he does. May the God we serve liberally, abundantly, bless you exceedingly more than you could ever ask. May he bless the work of your hands. May your family walk on one accord. May your children be saved, your cousins and them. May everybody come according to salvation. Joshua 24:15. May he overshadow and protect you like he says he will in Psalms 91. Remember, God knew you and he formed you. You are not a mistake. Your kids are not a mistake. May God bless you liberally with all that you need. May his kingdom come and his will be done in your health, in your finances, in every area of your life. In Jesus' name, amen. It's time for us to get out of here. We'll see you back Monday morning. Peace.
I like being independent, not so much of an investment. No one to tell me what to do. I like being by myself, don't gotta entertain anybody else. No one to answer to. But sometimes I just want somebody to hold, someone to give me the jacket when it's cold. Got that young love even when we're old. Yeah, sometimes I want someone to grab my hand. Pick me up, pull me close, be my hand. I will love you till the end. So if you're out there, I swear I'll be good to you. I'm the looking for future someone. Cause when the time is right, you'll be here. But for now, hear no one says your love song. Ooh, oh. I don't really like big crowds.